वेलकम बैक टू आवर चैनल फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज सोनिया हियर फ्रॉम ग्रोइंग क्राफ्ट। थैंक यू सो मच फॉर ड्रॉपिंग इन। नाउ बिफोर वी स्टार्ट दिस वीडियो, प्लीज डू मेक श्योर दैट यू सब्सक्राइब टू आवर चैनल एंड डू नॉट फॉरगेट टू हिट द बेल आइकन सो दैट यू डू नॉट मिस आउट एनी ऑफ आवर अपडेट्स। ऑल्सो डू चेक आवर वेबसाइट www.growingcraft.com एंड लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। Now this is a beautiful pattern paper from Dress My Craft. I have already pre-cut this to the size of my envelope. So here I am going to use a ready-made envelope. If you want, you can make the envelope from the scratch. I will of course mention the link, the tutorial of how to make envelope in the description box. Do check that. Now I am marking a center of my paper so that I can make a circle, and I am going to cut around that line. How I am going to do it? I am going to divide my circle like the pizza shape, and I am going to have around 8 to 10 folds here. So as you can see me here marking this with my pencil and my scale, and once I am done with this, then we are going to start with our cutting work. Now for cutting this, I highly recommend you to have a cutting mat. That's really important, otherwise your bases, your tables are going to just get ruined off. So please do use cutting mats before this step. Now for cutting these, I am using my Fisker paper knife, and these are one of the best tools for the paper crafter whenever it comes to these knees kind of cutting work. Otherwise, I have also seen some of the amazing paper trimmers at Crafters Corner. I'll try to share that link in the description box. Do check that. Now, on the back side, I'm going to use another pattern paper. Now, this is blue in color. This is completely contrast to the what I have used in the front, but it is from the same paper pack. And I'm going to stick it on the back side. Now, this is a very important step. You have to make sure that you do this really correctly. Otherwise, your whole design is just going to get ruined off. So you need to stick your papers on the reverse side, as your pattern should be on the complete opposite side, like it should be visible from the back side. Now once I'm done with the sticking work, ideally I should have let it dry for some time because I have used my liquid adhesive, but I was losing my patience and I was so excited to make this one. Now again with the same Fisker's knife, I'm going to cut along the same margins which I had already done. So you have to be really careful when you are doing this, and you need to make sure that you do not overcut this, do not undercut this, otherwise your shapes are not going to come out really well. So as you can see, like, this is how each flap is going to just come out, and you need to be really careful when you are doing this cutting work. Bonheur est passé à deux doigts de nos lèvres, deux doigts si fins que j'ai presque pu le goûter. Le bonheur a sculpté de son ciseau d'enfer des souvenirs impossibles à effacer. So as my paper was really thick, I had to use my scissor here, and you can see that how easily I was able to cut this just because I had used my paper knife. So it was pretty easy for me to cut these slices here. Now once I'm done with this, I'm just going to use my brown ink pad and do a little of distressing just to finish off the edges. This is completely optional. Now it's time to start the main work of this. So here what I'm going to do is I'm using my glue drops. These are one of the amazing adhesives what we can use. Now I'm cutting these into halves and I'm going to stick it on each of the slices what we have cut. Now honestly, I'm considering this as my pizza slices because then it will be easier for you to understand that how we are going to work on this. We are going to add the adhesives on each and every slices whatever we had done the cutting work. Now once you see this, you just need to roll up your slices to the front side. The front side is where you have used the bigger size pattern paper, and once you do it, then you will see a beautiful shape coming out. Now as you can see, I had used the contrast color pattern paper from the same paper pack, so it is really popping out so well and so beautifully that this is looking gorgeous. Now this is done and it's time to move on to the next step. So Dress My Craft from Crafters Corner, they have some of the amazing border punches. They have some of the amazing lace dies which you can use. So here I'm using one of the circle border punch, and I'm just using the contrast color combination paper for my upper decoration part. So I will be using my border punches and my laces for the decoration work. Now all these are my leftover pieces from my previous projects. If you want, you can pick up the shapes and different designs whichever you want, and I hope that you are going to like that. Now just because we have these punches and the dies, your work becomes absolutely easy and amazing. And honestly, the dies and the punches of Dress My Craft, the Crafters Corners, are to die for. Like, they are absolutely amazing, and you are not bound to use it in one way. Like, there are so many ways in which you can use your just one punch. Now here adding my cardboard pieces beneath my border punch, because I wanted to give it a nice 3D effect, and as my center flower has a nice 3D popping out effect, I just felt that this is going to match really well. So this is one of my favorite color combination from Dress My Craft Opulent Paper Pack. It has some of the amazing black designs on which I'm going to work really soon. So yes, do stay tuned to my channel. Now it's time to add up some more shades and some more color. And of course, in the backing, I wanted to have the nice contrast pink color blending with my shades. So I have just taken up a small pink color, same pattern paper, and I'm going to stick it at the back. And now you can see that it looks like that flower is popping out from the same envelope. Like I mentioned earlier also, that I love their dies, and this is one of their lace dies. And of course, I'm listing all the supplies links in the description box. You can check that, and you can check out the collections they have, and I'm sure you're going to love this. Now for sticking these laces, I am using my liquid adhesive. So in this project, I have broadly used only two adhesives. That is, one is my glue drop, the second one is liquid adhesive. If you want, you can even go for the tacky tapes, and it's absolutely fine. End of the day, your project should come out good. End of the day, you should be happy that you were comfortable with whatever the supplies you have used. Now, once I am done with the sticking work of my paper border laces, then I'm going to stick these beautiful yellow stones. And this is just to add a little more drama to my envelope. So honestly, if you want, you can play around with the embellishments on the top of it. You can have MDF cutouts, Ganesha, and all the coins, or anything, any other embellishments you want to. But with this beautiful paper pack, I just thought of keeping it really simple. Now having my same cardboard pieces at my envelope base also, so that I can stick this complete sheet on the top of it. And once I apply my liquid adhesive, I'm going to press it well and stick it well, and my money envelope is done. So I really hope that you all enjoyed this tutorial. Just in case if you guys have any query, please do comment below. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Take care, and do not forget to subscribe to our channel. Take care. Bye bye. Deux doigts de nos lèvres, deux doigts si fins que j'ai presque pu le goûter, le bonheur à sculpter, le son si